person's, he's having to be patient. Somebody else is getting their breakthrough. Mm. And while they're getting their breakthrough, Jairus and his daughter's life is slipping slowly from her. Mm. Which leads me to tell you sometimes, my brother, my sisters, there will be a pause in your breakthrough.
Yeah.
Sometimes there will be a delay in your breakthrough. But nowhere in the text do I read where Jairus rushed Jesus.
Yeah.
Nowhere in the text do I read where Jairus tried to hurry Jesus along. Nowhere in the text
preach
do
I that, even believe that,
where
Jairus
tried to get mad or get upset at the woman who was getting her breakthrough.
Yes, sir.
That's where exegesis comes in. Look here. If it had been us, yeah. Hey, you get to Jesus first. You ain't get to him. It's my turn. You can get him back now and get through. But notice Jairus doesn't get upset. Leaving y'all too far back. When God is blessing somebody else, you don't have to get upset. You don't have to get agitated. You don't have to get mad. Because just because your blessing has been delayed doesn't mean it's been denied.
Yeah.
Sometimes you have to wait on the Lord.
That's right.
Sometimes you have to be patient. And sometimes God will put you to the test. Sometimes he'll hold off your miracle just to see if you're really trusting and believing in him. It's like, and I preach this here. And when Lazarus, Mary and Martha came to Jesus, they sent word to him, saying our brother lies ill. They sent word to Jesus early, but Jesus delayed his coming.
Yeah.
And when he got there, Lazarus had already died. But Lazarus was resurrected once again. Look here, my brother, my sisters. Just because Jesus may delay your miracle doesn't mean he's forgotten about you.
That's right. That's right. That's a good word.
I got to, I'm way past my time. I got to hurry and close. The Bible says that after he deals with her, a person from the house comes to Jairus and says, look here, thy daughter is dead.
Yeah.
Troubleth not the master anymore. I mean, he wasn't even trying to break it easy to him. He wasn't even trying to be, he just said, your daughter, she dead. Leave him. You know, some people just don't know how to break that news.
Right. That's right.
Some folks just don't know how to, I mean, let's be honest, some folks don't know how to break bad news.
Yeah.
Your daughter is dead.
Uh-huh.
Now, can you imagine the hurt on Jairus' face? Because it's every parent. Look here. The parent's worst nightmare is having to bury their own child.
Yes, sir.
And so, Jesus eavesdrops and hears what this servant has to say. And he told Jairus, look here. Don't worry about what they're saying.
Uh-huh.
Focus on what I'm saying. And that's a word for us in here. Too many times when we go through our problems, we tend to listen to the wrong folk.
Yeah.
You don't need to listen to what they got to say. You need to hear what God has to say. God has the final word. He says, do not be afraid. Only believe. Well, I got to close. Not only do we see Jairus' position. Not only do we see Jairus' problem. Not only do we see the person Jairus went to, not only have we considered the pause and the progress of Jairus.
Yeah.
Lastly, we see the power of Christ.
Yeah.
The Bible says when Jesus gets to the house, the professional mourners are all in place.
Yeah.
And you know, back then when people died, they hired professional mourners.
Yeah.
People that just showed up, they don't even know the deceased.
Yeah.
They just show up. And make a whole bunch of noise.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, you got people like that today.
Preach that.
I know you got that problem in Lincoln, Texas. But in Nacogdoches, we got folks that show up at people's funerals. They don't know who it is. They just show up. And they are acting a fool in this house. They're crying. They're wailing. They're rolling on the floor. Jesus walked into the room and said, what is going on in here? What's all this turmoil? What's all this ado? The child ain't dead. She's asleep. Now, here's how you can tell that these were fakers. As soon as he said that, those folk that were crying started laughing.
help us.
A second ago. But now you're laughing. So here's what Jesus does. Jesus said, well, since you don't believe me, all y'all can get out. He put them all out.
Yeah.
And look here, there's some folk in your life that you just got to get out.
Yeah. Preach that, preach that, preach that.
For another time, but he takes Peter, James, and John. He takes his inner circle. He takes his mother and the father. Goes up to the room.
Uh-huh.
We see the power of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ looks at this little girl. Jesus Christ doesn't take out a prayer cloth. Jesus Christ doesn't take out a miracle water.
Say that, say that.
All Jesus does is speak.
Yeah.
He says, Talithi kumai.
Uh-huh.
Which is to say, a.k.a. damsel, arise. And the Bible says he took that little girl by the hand.
Yeah.
And that little girl that was dead, that little girl that did not have life in her body, Jesus took her by the hand and she arose. All Jesus did was just speak the word. Because there's power even in his word. Jesus showed us that he has the power over death. This ain't the first time Jesus raised somebody from the dead. I just told you he raised Lazarus, who had been dead in the grave for 4 days. He raised a little woman's son, who also been dead. But that ain't the only time that Jesus had power over death. One Thursday evening, they arrested him. Friday morning, they marched him from Caiaphas. They took him from Caiaphas and sent him to Annas. Annas sent him to Pontius Pilate. Pontius Pilate sent him to Herod. Herod sent him back to Pilate. That's the thing what they said. They marched him from judgment hall to judgment hall.
Come on,
son. They put nails in his hand. They put nails in his feet. They stretched him wide and he died.
Today.